Good evening, sirs. On Thursday, Rafael Ibanez says, when you defeat the All Blacks, you're a different player. Antoine, do you feel like you're a different player? And Fabien, did you see different players on the pitch tonight? I don't know. It's very difficult to say right now. I don't think that we are fully aware of what we've just achieved. But it feels incredible. I mean, I can't remember when the last time was. So tonight we're just going to enjoy and then we'll take stock of the situation. I think there was a second part in the question. The question was also for Fabien. Oh, did I see different players? In the preparation, I saw my players who were ready, who were determined, who were self-confident. That's what I felt during the last 4 weeks. I felt like the team was developing and building itself, looking forward to coming up for this match. And the team was there today. They delivered for 2 hours. Good evening, Fabien, Alexandre Priam, Sud Radio. It's the biggest win for France over New Zealand in the whole history of rugby. Is this a message you're sending tonight with this victory in this atmosphere? Well, it will be a milestone because it's the 20th match since we started with this new team, with the players who were here. So it was an important milestone to continue living with the same intensity in international rugby and the matchs we're going to play. So the autumn series and the last match against the All Blacks was an appointment. And we were there. Obviously, the result is very positive and it's going to bring us lots of reasons to be happy. It's a great moment for the players. It's also a moment when they will feel like they grow. Their self-confidence is growing and they can set objectives and aims for the future to continue growing.
Bonsoir, Fabien.
Fabien, good evening.
When
Romain went to the counter-attack, we felt like the match was actually going over. Absolutely, it was an incredible moment in the match. Beginning of the second half, we had a slightly weak and then a very weak moment. Quite surprising, this doesn't normally happen at that time in the game in our team. And then we felt like Romain and then the other players supporting Romain said, no, this is it. We're going to take control again. And so that ball, you know, the fact that there were three players around Romain was made a difference. The idea was to chase every single ball, including in our side of the pitch, and reorganize ourselves to give ourselves options. And the fact that he had three players next to him allowed him to go on the counter-attack and go back to the All Blacks line. It's as if Romain and his co-player said, enough, we've given you enough points in the second half, that's it.
Antoine,
what do you remember of this action? Can you tell us how you saw it from inside, from the pitch? Well, we'd already lost one try, maybe two, I can't remember. But their kicking game was very good, and we tried to regroup to find some comfort and provide Romain some solutions, because he didn't know exactly whether he had the ball in the goal line, so he decided to launch a counter-attack, and then we finished 5 meters from their line with a yellow card, so that was an action that was felt good, give us back our confidence, and we decided to stop allowing them to dominate. Maybe our pride was back, and that was a very good moment. Question for Antoine.
Tu as vécu ta plus belle soirée en
was
bleu,
this your most beautiful match
le podium,
as a French player?
Well, it
ranks among the top three. I mean, it's on the podium. We were there, our fans were there, our families were there, the scenario was perfect. All the conditions were met tonight for a beautiful victory that we will remember forever. Question for both of you. Can we talk about a reference match tonight against one of the best rugby teams? Difficult to say, but as Fabien said, it's an important milestone in our adventure, playing against the best teams. And we can show now that we are at the right level and we can continue developing from this match. I mean, you know, we also were scared at some stage. We felt like the match could have gone over to the other side, but we remained cool-headed and we were able to the match. And we're going to learn from that. Question for Antoine. The New Zealanders insisted on the fact that the audience was very noisy, that they were clearly supporting you. Did you feel it? Of course. As soon as we walked on the pitch, I've never heard the French anthem sounding so loud. We felt like the audience was really believing in us and they wanted us to do this tonight, to achieve it tonight, and we felt like they were supporting us in the very important moments. I felt like it was better to be a French player tonight than a New Zealander. Fabien, can you tell us about the turnaround regarding strategy with the mid-pitch? Why was it important to take this turnaround? Well, during the last 4 weeks, we worked on several strategies. I mean, the practice is open, everybody can watch. So we sometimes worked with 5-8, sometimes with two center punchers, sometimes with a forward pack, and sometimes playing along the axis. And we were prepared because we knew that this was a very important weapon we wanted to be able to use and also alternate depending on the matches. The team was well prepared and played the right way. That was very important. We played the right way and that protected us from the weak moments that Antoine was referring to earlier. Question for Fabien. It's the first time that the French national team wins all three test matches since 2012. So what is your assessment of this autumn series? Well, three victories, but we're on a path that is going to take us well beyond the autumn series. So it's a bit too early to assess what we have done, but the way we manage the group, the way we organize the autumn series, the 42 players, you know, we felt like the players were really supporting each other and they played as a team. We have a shared experience. And now you've seen this over the last 20 matches. It helps us be in the match until the end. There was not a single match when we were not in a position to win, although we ended up losing some of the matches. So that's something that we're learning. The team is collectively very united. It has lots of weapons available. When you went back to the locker rooms, you were leading 24-6. What happened? What did you think, Antoine? And Fabien, what did you tell them? What was your pep talk to keep the same intensity during the second half? Well, the aim was to keep going, not lose steam, because we knew how the New Zealanders would feel like when they walked out of the lockers, the changing rooms, and back onto the pitch. So we said, okay, we should not relax. We have to keep going. We put ourselves under some pressure, especially the first kickoff, second half, it didn't go very well, but we remained in the right direction and we didn't give in. My pep talk during the halftime break was mostly based on tactical issues. I also checked the physical condition and the mental condition of the players, and I told them what we can do better. I mean, the content was all right, attacking, defending, that was okay, but we gave them easy points, easy penalties that allowed them to come back into our half pitch and score 6 points, although they only scored 6 points, they did score those points. And at the beginning of the second match, the second half, they also had scored easy points, so that was the idea. And our aim was to be in the match at the 60th minute with the finishing players, and that was our strategy.
Gentlemen,
Fabien, does this result make you feel like you are a potential candidate for world champion? I don't think that this match can make us a candidate for world champion. I mean, it's experience. It's how we have prepared for the last 2 years that makes us candidates for the World Cup. It's just an ambition. It's a way of life. This result is only the consequence of our way of life.
Bonsoir, messieurs.
Good evening, sir.
Fabien, quelle est la
Fabien,
priorité aujourd'hui?
What is your priority now in the game?
Améliorer.
What is the area of the game you want to improve following these three matches to continue making progress and to contemplate more good results? What do you think? I don't know. Well, I'm asking my team leader what he thinks because he leads the game. But he says the question was for me. Thank you very much for your clear-headed support. Anna, he said, okay, we try to stay at the same level all the time. Well, you know, immediately after the game, it's very difficult. We finished the autumn series, and we're going to enjoy the satisfaction. It's very important to be able to enjoy the satisfaction. We're going to talk about rugby, but in a with a lighter head. It's very difficult immediately after the match to say what area needs to be improved. Obviously, the New Zealand team was setting the standards very high. So we will start analyzing the match on Monday within the staff. And the day after the match, we start talking among us, the staff, and then the following day, we talk to the players. Obviously, there are things we can improve, but remaining at the same level would already be very good. That would mean that we are a team that needs to be reckoned with. Fabien, based on the scenario, I mean, there's no discussing the victory. But did you think that your team was capable of dominating the best rugby team in the world like this, or were you surprised by what you did tonight? I mean, the first half, everything was okay. The French team was just choking the New Zealand team. It was self-confident. What we felt was that these players are self-confident, they believe in what they can do collectively as a group. And that's how they live during the week. It's a team that tries to keep it simple. And we need to share that with you. It's not going to change our vision. We're not going to start thinking we are someone different. We will welcome the victory because it belongs to us, but we will not think that we are someone else. The team we are building is what matters. It's a milestone, it's a stage, it's match number 20 on a path. One last question.
Fabien,
if you think about Melvin Jaminet's match, he was there when for Romain Tamac's counter-attack. He was there in Australia. Do you think he is
le terme que vous voulez utiliser qui permet
what do you, how will you qualify he's got that light-headed sort of playing and the way he plays, the way he helped Romain Tamac in his counter-attack, how do you qualify that? Well, I felt that he was well surrounded, the more experienced players were supporting him, and that really matters. Players have to find their own position. I think he's found his position in the team. Although he was in the team in Australia, but that was a different team, so he had to find his place in this particular team, so he looked around, he watched the other players, and he understood. And then he delivered a very, very high-level performance, but that's how he works. Well, you're talking about Romain's counter-attack, but when Romain had the ball in the goal line, he had support, he had other players, including Melvin. And the defense was puzzled, and Romain had several options. And it allowed our team to go so close to their goal line. So Melvin is just like the rest of the team. He's self-confident. He's happy within the group.
Merci, he's comfortable.